Welcome to the University of Lethbridge in Alberta. Training ground for the Canadian throws team as they prepare for the Commonwealth Games in July. They are among the oldest athletic events in existence. Hammer throw, shot put, javelin, discus. And they all involve centrifugal force, momentum, and many other concepts I failed to grasp in high school physics. And this is Larry Stanky. He is the coach of the national throwing team. Hello, Larry. How are you?
I'm well, thanks.
Nice to see you, sir. You have a nice facility here at the University of Lethbridge.
Thank you very much.
You are also the track coach.
Yes.
Of the horns.
Yes, pronghorns.
Now, the Commonwealth Games are coming up. And are these athletes ready for the Commonwealth Games?
They will be in a couple months' time.
Yeah. Sure. And now, of course, you're going to take time out of their training schedule and throw me in the mix to kind of...
Yes, you're going to disturb our practice for at least...
I wouldn't call it that. And this is Peter Millman. The sport is shot put. Hello, Peter. How are you?
Well, Rick.
Tell me about it. How does one get into shot put?
Well, I started out as being a hurdler, but sometimes they tell you that you're just too fat for a sport and moved on to the shot put.
I always got just too uncoordinated and weak. This is how many pounds?
This one is 13 pounds.
You take that back, because I can't break out in the sweat quite so early. Are there smaller balls? Yes, there are. I think I should go with the 2K.
Okay, we'll keep you with the 2K.
What is the technique?
Spin around to here, step to the middle, to the front, and throw it down the sector.
Okay, and where do you put the ball?
Well, the ball goes on your fingertips,
uh-huh.
And you press it right up against your neck.
That's impressive. What happens if you go out of the circle?
It's a fault, doesn't count.
It doesn't count.
Yeah.
It's like Stephen Harper. You step out of his circle, you are dead. Never to return.
Perfect.
Look. Thank you. Went straight, though.
It did go straight.
I've done worse at easier things, let me tell you. Very impressive. You are a large, strong man, right? And you just... threw that ball 16 pounds all the way down there. What do you think the chances are, I'm just saying, that I could get a ball to go further?
It's not gonna happen.
Yes!
Good technique.
I found my game. And this is Jim and Heather Stacy, and they are a brother and sister hammer throw team. You competed in London at the Olympics representing Canada. You were one of, what, two or three brother-sister teams?
Yeah, on all of Team Canada, I think there was only a couple sets of siblings.
What does it take to be a good hammer thrower? Because you and I are about physically the same size, right? What does it take?
It takes a lot of technical work, and, like, figuring out the footwork takes a lot of time.
How many times do you go around in the circle?
I go four times. Jim goes four times. Some people do three.
Oh, really? It's up to you?
Yeah.
Like if I wanted to develop a 2.5 or a 7?
Yeah.
You're too young to remember Wonder Woman, aren't you? On television?
On television, yeah.
Yeah, when you spin around, I tell you, I thought, boom, you were going to be in a whole new outfit. So I stood here,
yeah.
And I took one in the chest.
That would kill you.
Okay, I'll be outside the net. All right, am I safe here?
You are.
How far was that?
About 65 meters.
Do you guys have to fetch your own hammers?
We do.
Is that part of the charm of the sport?
No.
Even this part feels dangerous to me. It's like a little wrecking ball video here. A little mini wrecking ball video. I gotta get it out of the cage. That's my goal. Never mind 65 meters. Hey! Whoa. Not bad. Personal best. Where's your personal best? Show me. Hey!
Hi, Rick.
So I've got a ways to go. And this is Ryan Summers, silver medalist at the Canada Summer Games. Hello, Ryan, how are you?
Good, how are you doing?
Where are you from, sir?
White Rock, British Columbia.
White Rock, and the sport is discus, correct?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, well, I think everyone has seen the art. In order to do it, you have to be naked, right?
That works best.
And you've got a bigger one than me.
Yeah, I do.
I have a compact discus.
How many calories a day do you eat as an athlete?
3,700 calories.
How do you eat 3,700 calories?
It doesn't feel good, but you just got to do it. It helps.
You got to do it. You got to do it. You got to get the go to Dairy Queen. You got to get the ice cream cake.
For the love of the sport, you just got to do it.
Full throw.
Full throw. You want a grunt?
Yes. Yes, Martina. There you go. Okay, it's my turn. Okay. Should I take the gloves off?
Yeah, take the gloves off.
Well, it's cold.
Are you gonna pivot on your right foot, on your left foot?
Like that?
No, other way.
What? Hang on. Okay. What?
So it's pivot, step.
Oh my God, we're in a horrible dance class. So we're gonna go like this.
Just like that. There you go.
Okay. Woo! See, the leg went up. Oh, do you get dizzy?
No.
Because I'm a little out of breath and disoriented. The way Rob Ford sees the world. How many calories did you say you eat in the run of a day?
3,700 calories.
And you like pizza?
I love pizza.
And today, this show will answer the question that has been asked for decades. Which will fly further, thin crust or deep dish? Okay, are you deep dish or thin crust?
I'm a deep dish guy.
They're still in the plastic, so you can take them home and eat all six before lunch.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you, Rick.
Good luck on everything. I slipped the discus.